Hello friends, welcome to all of you. Now we are going to discuss about the March 12th top 5 MCQs of the day. This is presented by me, Sai Ishwareshwant. You can subscribe to the channel IAS 366 and then click on the bell icon to get regular notifications. If you have not clicked the bell icon, kindly click it so that you will get all the updates. You can even follow me on the Unacademy platform. You can search for my name, for Sai Ishwareshwant, and from there you can follow me. The link is provided in the description box. So use the referral code Sai Ishwareshwant to get 10% instant discount on all the Unacademy Plus subscriptions. If you are going for the Plus subscription for 1 month, 6 months or 12 months, use this referral code Sai Ishwareshwant so that you will get 10% instant discount on all the Plus subscriptions. And you can follow me on the Unacademy platform. These are the courses that I am currently presenting there. And the second course is the top 5 MCQs of the day. The questions that now I am presenting are different from the questions that I am presenting on the Unacademy. So if you are watching both these videos, daily you will be getting 10 MCQs. So daily solving 10 MCQs will be sufficient for you to clear the prelims examination. So don't neglect the current affairs MCQs. Let us start with the first question now. Do mention what is your score out of 5 in the comment section. Consider the following statements regarding Integrated Child Development Services Scheme, ICDS. Let us see the statements. It provides food, preschool education, primary health care, immunization, health checkup and referral services to the children under 6 years of age. This is important. Under 6 years of age and their mothers. Yes, this is a correct statement. There is nothing wrong in this. It will be providing all these facilities to the children. What is the second statement? It is under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Whether it is a correct statement or not, if you have observed the first statement very keenly, then you can say that this scheme is relating to children and also their mothers. That is, children is there in the scheme and also mother is there in the scheme. So what is the ministry that comes? It is nothing but Women and Child Development Ministry. So you should be able to grasp the statements from the first statement itself. So second is wrong here because it is the Women and Child Development Ministry. First is correct, second is wrong. So the correct answer here will be A. That is one only. Let us see the explanation. The Integrated Child Development Services Scheme is a government program in India which provides food and preschool education, primary health care and immunization, health checkup and referral services to the children under 6 years of their age and their mothers. So it is under the Women and Child Development Ministry. So please remember, the ICDS scheme is under the Women and Child Development Ministry but not under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Let us see the next question, question number 2. Consider the following statements regarding green crackers. So green crackers were in news because the Supreme Court has directed the various organizations to prepare the green crackers. Let us see the statements now. These crackers does not emit any kind of smoke. Absolutely rubbish statement. So there are no crackers currently which will not produce any kind of smoke. But the advantage with the green crackers is it will produce less smoke. It is not no smoke, it is less smoke. So the first statement is wrong here. What is the second statement? They will have same light effect and same sound intensity as that in the conventional crackers. Yes, this is a correct statement. The green crackers will be having the same light effect and also the same sound intensity as that of in the available in the conventional crackers. So the first is wrong, second is correct. Hence the correct answer here will be B. That is two only. Let us see the explanation. Green crackers will have same light effect and same sound intensity as that is present in the conventional crackers. Their usage will result in the reduced emission of hazardous PM2.5. So we have two PMs, like the particulate matter 2.5 and the particulate matter 10. So these green crackers will be reducing the particulate matter 2.5 because particulate matter 2.5 is more hazardous than the particulate matter 10. These will be directly entering into the lungs and it will affect them. So Council for Scientific and Industrial Research, that is CSIR, and NERI, the National Environmental Engineering Research Institute, have been entrusted by the Supreme Court of India to develop the green crackers. You should remember these two organizations also. CSIR and NERI were the ones that were entrusted by the Honorable Supreme Court to develop green crackers. These crackers are not smoke free but produce less smoke. So they are not completely or absolutely smoke free. They will just produce the less amount of smoke. These are the features of the green crackers: low air and sound pollution, reduced emissions of NO and also SO2, ash free crackers, and particulate matter reduced by 25 to 30%. So this will be reducing the particulate matter, that is PM2.5, by 25 to 30%. So please remember about the green crackers. Let us see the next question. Question number 3. Consider the following statements regarding molasses. Let us see the statements. Molasses is an important component in making sulai, which is an intoxicant drink. Yes, this is a correct statement. So molasses is the key factor in this sulai, and this is an intoxicant drink. First statement is correct here. What is the second statement? Kerala state government has recently banned molasses. Whether it is a correct statement or not, if you are reading the newspapers very carefully, there is a tragedy that is going on in the state of Assam regarding these intoxicant drinks, and Assam is the state that has banned the molasses but not Kerala. So please be careful while seeing, relate the statements to the news that were happening in the country. In that way you can come to the correct answer. First is correct, second is wrong here, because it is the Assam state but not Kerala. So the correct answer here will be A, that is one only. Let us see the explanation. Here you can see this molasses. So molasses is a thick dark brown juice obtained from raw sugar during the refining process, and Assam Chief Minister Sarbananda Sonowal has recently ordered a ban on molasses in the state in the aftermath of the huge tragedy in the two districts, which claimed 158 lives. So 158 people lost their lives in the Hooch, and the tragedy is called as the Hooch tragedy. That is the reason the Assam Chief Minister has banned this. Molasses is an important component in making sulai, which is an intoxicant drink widely consumed in the tea gardens of Assam. So it is from the state of Assam but not Kerala. Here the second statement is wrong here. So correct answer here will be A, that is one only. Sorry for this. Let us move on to the next question. Question number 4. Consider the following statements regarding Saral satellite. We have already discussed about the Saral satellite in the Hindu prelims analysis. So please answer this correctly. What is the first statement? It was designed to measure the polluted areas of the ocean and the type of pollution. And what is the second statement? It is a joint Indo-French satellite mission. Whether this statement is correct here, because this Saral satellite is by India and France. It is a joint initiative of India and France. What about the first statement? It is a wrong statement, because the main purpose of this Saral satellite is not to measure pollution, rather it is for the maritime surveillance. It is for the maritime surveillance but not to measure the pollutant or the pollution. So first is wrong and second is correct. So the correct answer here will be B, that is 2 only. Let us see the explanation. The National Space Agency ISRO and its French counterpart CNES sealed an agreement to set up a joint maritime surveillance system in the country by May 2019. SARAL, what is the full form of SARAL? Satellite with Argos and Altica, is a cooperative altimetry technology mission of ISRO and CNES, that is the space agency of the France. SARAL will perform altimetric measurements designed to study the ocean circulation and also the sea surface elevation. So it is not the pollution. Here you can see the Saral satellite, and it is a joint project of India and France. You should remember the countries also. Here instead of France, UPSC may ask some other nation. So please remember, this Saral is with the France. On to the next question, the fifth and final question for the day. Which of the following countries has signed the New Delhi Declaration on Asian Rhinos 2019? Very, very important one. It is relating to the environment and ecology, and it is also declaration thing. So very important. Let us see the statements. What are the options given here? Indonesia, India, Bangladesh, Malaysia. So what are the, there are 5 nations under these Asian rhinos. So what are those nations? Indonesia, Malaysia, India, Bhutan, and what is other nation? It is nothing but Nepal. So these 5 are the nations that were present in this New Delhi Declaration on Asian rhinos. So check from the options. Indonesia is there, yes. India is there, yes. Bangladesh is not there, Malaysia is there. So apart from this, there is also other countries like the Nepal and also Bhutan. So what is the correct answer here? 1, 2 and 4. C is the correct answer. Let us see the explanation. The New Delhi Declaration on the Asian Rhinos 2019 has recently been signed by 5 rhino range nations. And what are those nations? India, Bhutan, Nepal, Indonesia and India. For the conservation and protection of this species, at the recently held 2nd Asian Rhino Range Countries meeting, which was held in New Delhi, and that is the reason the declaration was named as the New Delhi Declaration. The declaration was signed to conserve and review the population of the greater one-horned rhinoceros, Javan, and also the Sumatran rhinos every 4 years. This is also very important. The site will be, the population will be reviewed for every 4 years in order to reassess the need for joint actions to secure the future of rhinos. Please remember. Let us move on to the next one. So we have completed the questions. Kindly go to the playlist section and start the revision now itself. Finish all the MCQs of March and then come to the February and then finish the January and also December MCQs. So please start the revision now itself. Don't wait for the prelims examination. It will be very beneficial for you if you are completing the entire MCQs revision now itself. Thank you for watching this video, friends. If you have liked the video, hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel IAS 366, and also share this video. Do share this video with all your friends so that they can also learn these MCQs. And also you can join our Telegram channel, the link for which is being provided in the description box. From that link you can join our Telegram channel. Thank you for watching this video, friends. Thanks a lot.